tell a story through art, you tell a story through media. And, you know, the Chicano movement here in the 60s and 70s, the struggles, and it is our roots, it is who we are, you know, defines us. And who was archiving that? Who was documenting that? And that was something that Chon just had, you know, a passion for, and he pulled it off.
It takes courage, commitment, perseverance, and an understanding of how valuable and important it is. And Chon Noriega gets that.
Chon has that quiet determination that is perceptive, that is incisive. He doesn't take things for granted. He doesn't allow others to take things for granted. He speaks out in a very quiet, sophisticated way, but he speaks out.
The Chicano Studies Research Center was founded in 1969. I've been directing since 2002, and in that time, what it's really done that's unique is combine library and archive, academic press, research across the disciplines, and an engagement with the community, whether through partnerships or through research that's really designed to address pressing issues and ensuring equity for all.
He's got books that he's published, but he's also published books by others. He's probably one of the biggest publishers in the University of California system.
We've had a pretty significant and national impact in the arts in terms of pipeline programs, having transformative exhibitions, but also just changing the way one thinks about the arts and the way one thinks about the audience for art. I've been involved with LACMA for about 14 years through the center. I'm called a consulting curator.
He was instrumental in founding this curatorial program at LACMA that trains undergraduates in curatorial practice and exposes them. Only 3% of the leadership of museums is Latinx. So this kind of program could actually really make concrete changes by bringing new voices into the study of the arts. He's helped create and found this new field, the study of Latinx art, Latinx art. The art historical establishment, museum world, did not really accept or value Latino arts. So there were very few exhibitions. There were very few places you could get a PhD. Very few people publishing in this area, and he really single-handedly changed this.
When I was starting my dissertation, I realized I can write about these films, but no one's ever seen them. It was important for me to figure, well, how do we preserve these so that they're accessible, so that they can get into college libraries, they can be taught in classrooms. We're now archiving a lot of feature films and created a DVD series here so that they could be released.
His work has been fundamental to the study of these genres, to making visible the important contributions of Chicano artists all across the United States.
About 20 years ago, Chicano, Chicana, Latino, Latina filmmakers had no common agenda. There was an environment in which filmmakers were competing for crumbs. So one of the things that changed that was a group of about 20 people who came together to create Nalib, and Chon was one of them.
I was able to raise enough money through the foundations that we were able to have a real bare bones conference. For the first 5 years, I did what I could to maintain the foundation funding.
And so I saw him as a true colleague, a brother, a collaborator in a common struggle to bring us all together and to move us ahead so that filmmakers were able to pursue their careers with their ambition, with their aesthetics, with their creative motivations. And Chon has been there throughout.
years ago, hate speech was just beginning. It was just exploding.
They are sapping the state budget, taking jobs from legal residents, and swamping hospitals.
So the DJs, Spanish language DJs here in Los Angeles, decided we're going to bombard the Spanish language population as well as the English language Latino to come to City Hall and protest, saying hate speech must come down. Hate speech is not welcome in this city, it's not welcome in this country. So we commissioned UCLA, Chon Noriega, to do three studies for us. What is hate speech? Who was fanning those fires? We were able to show that hate crimes were being generated because of the hate speech. We were able to use the studies that the FCC for our constituents. We had a better understanding of what was going on. The one that brought this to light, Chon Noriega.
Chon Noriega does what he does because he loves his people. He loves our culture. He loves who we are. And he's there to preserve and document and support those who are creating our stories.
He sees the world through art, through film, through books. He is documenting this. He's documenting things that keep us rooted, that keep us grounded to where we come from. Like what's happening today in immigration and this, you know, horrendous stuff at the border where children are being separated from their parents. Those need to be documented and we can never forget. Chon is one of those people that's in the front lines of making sure we don't forget.